There's no reason that these engines can't or shouldn't live a very reliable life to 200,000 plus miles. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the most common Honda 1.5 turbo engine problems and reliability. The Honda 1.5 liter turbo engine, also more formally known as the L15B and C, or the Honda Earth Dreams engine, began production in 2015 and remains a very popular Honda engine to this day. The 1.5 turbo is found in the Civic, the CRV, the Accord, as well as a few other models. This is a very popular engine that at this point has been around for just about a decade, and thanks to its turbocharged design, the Honda 1.5 liter inline four engine offers a good overall balance of performance and power, reliability, and efficiency. However, no engine is perfect, and that also applies to the Honda 1.5T, as it is prone to a couple issues that are more common than others. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common Honda 1.5T engine problems. Starting off with number one on the list, we have oil dilution. Fuel diluting the oil is really one of the more common issues and one of the more commonly discussed topics. Some fuel dilution in the oil is normal on just about any engine, and that's especially true with direct injected engines like the Honda L15. However, there have been some cases of rather excessive fuel dilution of the engine oil, and this excess oil dilution can be very detrimental to long-term reliability, and that's because if you have anything diluting the oil, that can reduce the oil's ability to properly lubricate the engine and all of those moving parts, and so it can be something that's detrimental in the long term, and something that Honda even addressed with some specific 2016 to 2018 models, where they actually offered an extended warranty with an additional year and unlimited mileage as compared to the standard 5-year 60,000 mile powertrain warranty. So this was something serious enough that caused Honda to actually address this. However, the one downside is when it comes to oil dilution, it can be something that, again, is mostly detrimental in the long term. And so it's possible that 1 year extra warranty in unlimited miles isn't really helping out with the lot, because sometimes these cases might not pop up until the engines are, you know, 10 plus years old and 100 plus thousand miles, when that overall wear from having oil that can't lubricate as properly really starts to build up and cause potential internal engine failures. Now, I don't want to spend too much extra time on the problem itself, and instead just want to jump into a few tips to help reduce oil dilution on the Honda L15. Number one, Honda initially recommended a 9,000 mile oil change interval, so it's not a bad idea to go ahead and shorten that, especially if you're doing a lot of shorter trips and in city driving. Shortening that oil change interval to 5,000 or 6,000 miles can ensure that you don't have any excessive fuel dilution of the oil. So stay on top of those oil changes at the very least, especially as these engines continue getting older and older. Continue shortening that oil change interval if you plan on owning the vehicle for the long term. Additionally, avoid any excessive idling, as while the vehicle is idling, that's a very common time for that fuel to actually sit on the cylinder walls and eventually be washed out and mix with the oil. And then lastly, before you really start beating on the car, make sure it gets up to proper operating temperature, so don't get into it and start giving it a lot of throttle on a very cold engine. That can introduce higher levels of fuel dilution in the oil. So again, pretty basic tips there. Moving on to the second most common issue, we have carbon buildup. Carbon buildup isn't really a significant issue on this Honda engine. However, considering the L15, B, and C are direct injected and don't have any fuel sprayed into the intake ports, there will be at least some degree of carbon buildup on the intake ports and intake valves. And the reason for that is all engines produce some natural amount of oil blowby, which makes its way back into the intake tract, notably again on the back of the intake valves and within the intake ports. Traditionally, if you had a port injected vehicle, the fuel would be sprayed into those intake ports and any detergents in the gasoline could actually wipe away those oil deposits. But with direct injection, you don't have any fuel spraying over that area. You don't have any detergents to help wipe away those deposits. So over time, that oil blowby starts caking to the back of the valves and the intake ports, and that leads to what's known as carbon buildup. Again, this isn't really something that's a serious issue or really anything to hold against this Honda engine particularly. It's just a fact of the matter, any engine that is direct injected only is going to experience some degree of oil blow-by and carbon buildup. Fortunately, it seems like the 1.5T handles this relatively well. A lot of these Honda 1.5T engines will probably go most of their lives, if not their whole life, without any issues or noticeable drivability problems due to the carbon buildup. However, over time, as those carbon deposits begin forming and building up more and more, that can interrupt airflow into the cylinders, which can mean that you can start experiencing power loss, rough idle, and potentially misfires. So if you're looking to own the Honda L15 for the long term, then it's not a bad idea to go ahead and get those intake valves walnut blasted every roughly 100 to 130,000 miles. But again, as a final note, it's a relatively small issue in the grand scheme, and many of these engines will likely go their whole lives without having any significant ill effects. Moving on to our third and final common problem for the Honda 1.5T, we have head gasket failure. I don't want to spend too much time talking about head gasket failures on this engine. It can and does happen on the L15 turbocharged engines. A lot of that boils down to the kind of boost and PSI that these engines are running. That leads to higher cylinder pressures, which can ultimately cause issues with the head gasket. This isn't a huge issue on stock vehicles. This mostly occurs for those starting to tune and modify the L15 turbo engine. Again, that's going to create even higher cylinder pressures, which can allow that head to start potentially lifting a little bit and ultimately result in head gasket failure. You might want to address that with ARP head studs and something that will help hold that head down a little bit better than the stock design. So it can and does happen on these engines in stock form, but it's not terribly common until you start modding it. It's just something to be aware of and something that's worth the mention, since head gasket failure can be a job that costs thousands and thousands of dollars to replace the head gasket. So it's something to check out and be aware of before you pull the trigger on one of these engines, especially if you intend to tune and modify it in the longer run. Anyway, that really wraps up some of the more common issues with the Honda 1.5T L15 engine. One thing I just want to point out before jumping in and really talking about overall reliability. In this video, I'm calling these the most common problems because they're things that tend to pop up more than other issues. That doesn't mean these are the only things that ever go wrong, nor does it mean they're truly common problems in the true sense of the definition of common. Instead, when things go wrong, these are a few of the more common areas and some of the more expensive things to be on the lookout for before buying this engine. So tying that into overall reliability, the Honda 1.5 liter turbocharged engine is a very reliable engine overall. It certainly earns above average remarks for reliability, in my opinion. Again, the oil dilution is something that can be serious in the long term and cause excessive wear and tear on the engine. But outside of that, carbon buildup is a relatively minor issue, and head gasket failures aren't that common. Even when you start tuning and modifying the engine, they're still not that common. It just becomes something to consider more and more if you are looking to add power. As a final note, one thing to keep in mind if you're used to Honda engines or mostly naturally aspirated engines of the past is that turbocharged engines do generally take a little bit more TLC and require a little bit more maintenance than your typical naturally aspirated engine. Turbo engines are very reliable in the modern days, but that still doesn't change the fact that these engines do like to burn through spark plugs, ignition coils a little bit quicker, and ultimately, if you want the best long-term reliability and performance, it's best to run higher grade fuels like 91 or 93 octane, which can increase the cost of owning and operating one of these vehicles. So just a couple things to consider there with the 1.5T, but otherwise maintain these engines well, stay on top of oil changes, do all of the basics, and there's no reason that these engines can't or shouldn't live a very reliable life to 200,000 plus miles. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.